I'm Ang Chui Pek. I was formerly in Petaling Jaya Gospel Hall as an elder. Then the work started in PJ, was 35 years ago.
At the beginning, yeah, Sunday school and prayer meeting started first.
First of all, having prayer meetings, and I remember those days our prayer meetings were held in the Uncle Yingkui's house. That was in SS1. Then Sunday school came over, started in Siu Tak's house. Then after that moved to Chong Hua's house. Before we actually had this building.
So that was Mr. Lim Peng San. He was influential and was holding quite a high position in the secular world. He managed to get a shop lot for us in SS2, one of the shop houses. And so we started the meeting there 35 years ago.
So when they have this place, so everybody come here to pray instead of going to people's house, no?
After a while, we felt that the meeting was getting quite big and we need expansion. So some years later, it was good to hear that the neighbor who owns the shop house next to us wanted to sell.
We were praying for that. To buy the shop lot, praying so hard. Then we all at prayer meeting was upset. We said, "Lord, the wall of Jericho come down." So after that, all the neighbor not supposed to sell the shop lot because this the father owns the lot. So somehow the son became a Christian. So talk to the father, and father all of a sudden told Uncle Singui, because I think they work at, Uncle Singui knows them very well. So he said, "We want to sell the lot to your church." So good, right? I remember we prayed at prayer meeting facing the wall and say, "Wall of Jericho, come down." That's so exciting. I'm like, "Really, it happened? Wow, you're all so excited."
And so we were able to possess it.
After that, we have two services. Then we see the Dagape Church started. We also see Puchong Bandar Gospel Center started. D-Y-L-A-N-N-G-N, I'll say it before and I'll say it again, you gotta love.
So those were good milestones in the church, all right. I think development wise, it is the people that are being built up, right? And I think what we can see that, you know, people are stepping forward to take on responsibility. That's important, all right? Because I don't think any one of us can do it all on our own. This is very much a church that is dependent on people stepping forward to give their heart and their life, because they are moved by the Spirit, moved by the love of God.
From my care group, quite a number of us here around, but I would like to say about the many who have gone out into the outreach to be leaders. That excites me to see Raja Segaran is the elder of Sunway. Chai is also elder of Chad Sunway. They were from the same care group. So I've moved from many care groups. Colin was here, Colin Gerton was here, and now Colin is also the elder of us. Subang. So many of those who were here have gone out, and then they are at the outreach group.
Well, I could see it wasn't easy. I remember there were tumultuous years in which when we began the kindergarten, that was quite to be there. There were a lot of pains that we have got to go through.
Well, we have ups and downs, but I mean, we have been together as a family. We have been going on together as a family, serving the Lord and moving forward for the Lord. It's not like one individual, it's like a family unit here.
Eventually now we see the result that we are able to bless the kindergarten work. We are able to bless a lot of other churches, reverend churches in the Klang Valley. Because I believe we were the first in the Klang Valley to actually have a kindergarten. First of the brethren churches.
Later on, the number increased, so we felt that there should be the expansion of the hall, and the ground floor was broken up and made as if it was a big hall.
From one building, and this is the one building. This is the one building. We acquired the next building. And after that, then, you know, we had expanded so much, we need to rent the other building, followed by Ebenezer at the back. At that time, we wanted to buy, of course, the next door, which is the Lot 18. But they are asking price, you know, on hindsight, I think it's pretty cheap, but I think we didn't have hindsight then, you know. So we thought that, you know, we aren't going to get that. And the prices were, of course, rising, and it's proven that, you know, now I think it's a lot more expensive than before. Then the thought came that perhaps instead of thinking laterally, we should think out of box as well. And instead of just another building beside us, right, why not think about a house behind us?
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace, streams of mercy.
Just before the 30th anniversary of the hall was made known public, and we invited friends to come. They asked me whether I could be able to choose the names. One of the names to be given to the house. So I chose the name Ebenezer, which means in English, hitherto hath the Lord helped us.
Thy great help I've come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely.
If God's people are willing to be faithful to Him, to trust Him, to undertake, sometimes you do not know whether, you know, that's going to be right decision, all right? But you need to trust, all right? Then I think what will show is God Himself will prove He's faithful in carrying out the things that He wants done.
I think God has been faithful, kind, and merciful to the members, to the people here. In many ways, you see God answering prayers, even members who are struck with terminal diseases like cancer, and they have been healed. That's a very tangible way of God showing His mercies. It is wonderful to see the younger ones growing up, even children, families growing up, and growing up in love for him and for one another, and that's also an evidence of his faithfulness.
Well, God has been faithful in every area, I think, because this is Sunday school for so many years, it's still going strong. And then the Sunday school children growing up, becoming the youth, some of them becoming, workers. Jesus saw me when a stranger, wandering from love for the God. He to rescue me from danger, interposed in his precious blood.
We say SSGC is a peace-loving church where the members care for one another.
SS is really Christ-centered and focuses on the Bible through everything and for everything.
SSGC is a very small family-oriented church. It's very warm, everyone knows each other, and the fellowship is quite strong.
I believe it is a community that is really grounding itself in the Word of God and trying to grow together in being more like Jesus.
It's a very family-oriented church. People are very, very caring and very sincere and very, very committed in trying to preach and share the gospel with. I think for me, it was the early years when we first started with the prayer meetings upstairs, where the group of us were gathered together every Wednesday. That has been a very fond memory for me.
For me, it was in 2003 when we came back from the mission field. And at that time, we would have come back after 20 years having left the church, back in 1983. And we felt like we were coming back home again.
The milestones that we have achieved as a family together, and also being able to see the church grow. And to be honest about it, I think the church has actually grown significantly over the years.
There are many fond memories, okay? Because current one is to see people coming to know the Lord Jesus Christ in Alpha. Very excited to see your family coming to know the Lord Jesus. So that excites me.
During kindergarten, like sometimes they will take us to go to the parks. And yeah, that's like the best part of, as far as I can remember, that's the best part.
Wow, heartwarming is like, that we see our children, they grew up, they were young from Sunday school, now they're all growing up and all worshipping the Lord and serving the Lord. That's very heartwarming, yeah. And some of us, even though we're old, we're still faithfully in the church.
I don't have a single fondest memory. I have many fond memories. Going to camp every year, although I've not managed every single year. I managed, you know, 2 out of the 3 years to go. It's been quite exciting. It was a great time to be able to know people in the church better and spend more time together.
I won't say that's a specific memory, but the whole YF section of my life was quite memorable.
To continue to grow and to expand in love.
I like to see SSGC making a greater impact to the community around this area, and I think that we will be able to do it. The recent activities, for example, like the Gotong Royong, I think it has actually reached out and to show that the community around us that SSGC is truly here, and I think we can do lots more.
I guess I would like to see SSGC, all the generations in SSGC being able to relate to each other and not segregated by different ages, but everyone as a whole, as one.
That SSGC would be a church whose members love God deeply, and there are people who have experienced change in their inner life, and as a result, they will impact the people and the community.
My wish for SSGC is that they continue in what they've been doing. I think there is a great grounding in the Word of God, and that's what attracted me in the first place to SSGC, and be able to really grow in my faith. So my wish is for SSGC to also continue to develop together in their life and growing spiritually.
My wish for SSGC is to prepare the next generation to reach out to the community. That's my wish.
Internally, I think we would like to raise more leaders.
SSGC will stand to be an enduring testimony for Jesus Christ for all ages, all right? And I think secondarily, that SSGC will be the center for sending out and raising up churches.
My wish is that they would be able to go out to form other assemblies and not stay put in only one.